Yo, this is Adonis T. Rivi, PhD student at UC Berkeley. I'm here to tell you, make sure you go to Gumby Publishing and check out Sean's YouTube channel, man.
Peace.
Yo, Sean, what is it?
I said astigmatism in my soul.
We in Gay Park, we in Brooklyn. My man, hey, what's up, man? What's your name, man?
Jamo.
What's up, Jamo?
I'm cool.
Jamo, where you from?
I'm from Grenada as well. That's my brother, Cali.
Oh, that's your biological brother?
Biological brother.
Okay, how old are you, Jamo?
I'm 34.
34?
Yeah.
All right, what section of Brooklyn you live in?
I live in Canarsie.
Canarsie?
Yeah.
Okay, that's a little ways from here, ain't it?
Yeah, it's a little like 10, 15 minutes, you know?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, Jamo, so listen now. So you saw you getting a little bit of that dip money.
Yeah.
Could you get some push-up money for us real quick, man?
Sure, man. No problem. I'll give you a set. 20 a set.
All right. 20 is a set?
Yeah.
What about 15?
15, no problem. That's nothing.
No, but I said 15 ain't no set, though.
No. 20.
All right. Y'all, Jamo, getting that good push-up money, y'all. Y'all see it? We in Gay Park, we in Brooklyn, man. Jamo from Canarsie.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, Jamo, you
34. Yeah.
34, all right. Now, you lean and shit. You ain't got no, you got your veins and shit showing. What do you eat, man?
Well, from growing up, I was allergic to, like, processed food. If I eat anything from a can, my skin would break out, so I never used to eat that. And even recently, I just started eating meat. I never used to eat meat. I was a vegetarian, so probably that's the reason why I'm so lean.
Okay, you know? So now you grew up that way?
Yeah, I grew up that way.
You grew up in Grenada?
I was born and grew in Grenada. I moved to Brooklyn like 12, 13 years ago. Yeah.
Now, so the people in Grenada, the foods y'all eat over there is a lot different than over here, right?
Yeah, it's strictly organic.
A lot of your shit is organic.
Yeah.
Motherfuckers ain't fat and shit over there like that.
No,
right?
No. Everybody is lean and slim, and you will find a few fat people, but
right.
I guess it's just the genetics, you know?
Right.
Yeah.
Now, Jamo, how many days a week you get money out here, man?
I try to do at least 4 days a week. You know, minimum, whether it be the gym or in the park.
Okay, so you fuck with the gym?
Yeah, I fuck with the gym sometimes. From work, I pass the gym on my way from work, so sometimes I will stop by because the park is out of my way, so, you know, either one.
Now, when you go to the gym, what do you do? You do a lot of heavy weights and shit?
I do heavy weights, but mostly on the legs because I don't feel like I get the leg workout that I want to get in, like by working out in the park.
Right.
So I do most of my leg workout at the gym.
Right. Now, Jamo, steroids, creatine, supplements?
Nah, no steroids. Maybe a little creatine every now and then, a little protein powder now and then, the plant-based protein from what's the guy name? Is it Ambrioso? Mike something. Shit, I forgot his name, but it's a plant-based protein that I use, you know?
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, what would be like your typical diet? What would you eat like in a typical day?
Like in the morning, I would do like egg with some home fries or like a raisin bagel, small coffee, and that would be like my first meal for the day. And then after that, I would have like a liter of water, and then I would have some fruits in between. Then later on in the evening, I eat some Caribbean food, like it might be provision with dumplings, saltfish, mixed vegetables. That's what I would have like around midday or early evening. And then at night, I just have something light, like some toast and some tea, and that's it.
Now, Jamo, you got that big-ass scar on your stomach, man.
Yeah.
What the fuck happened right there?
That was something from since I was a baby. Like, I think I had a cyst, but being that I was a baby, they couldn't make the incision small enough to get it out. So they had to split everything open, take everything out, get rid of it. And I grew up with the scar, so, you know.
Okay, okay. Yeah.
But I never had a problem ever since.
Okay. Now, gentlemen, what about your sleep and your rest? Is that important in your workouts, man?
Yeah, I love to sleep. I sleep minimum 6 hours a night. I try not to stay up too late. I usually hit bed like 9:30, 10 o'clock, and because I got to get up and get out by 6 in the morning, so I try to make sure I get minimum 6 hours to 8 hours sleep every night.
So how important is sleep to your workout and then to your mental focus the next day?
It's very important, because if you don't get enough rest, the next day your body is going to be sluggish, you're going to be tired, you're going to be getting a headache, you're going to have to eat more, and you know, all that would play into how efficient your body feel when it's time to work out. You know, you might feel too tired because you didn't get enough sleep. Your muscles are going to be fatigued very quick, you know, so it's very important to get rest.
Jamo, mental toughness, mental discipline, as far as working out to make sure, and mental discipline as far as eating proper foods and staying on course. Could you talk a little bit about that, the mental piece?
Yeah, the mental piece is the foundation of it. It's probably more important than sleep, you know, being mentally prepared, because you got to know what you want. You got to know why you're out here working out. You got to have a goal, like whether it be to lose weight, whether it be to shred, whether it be to bulking up. You got to be prepared, because depending on what your purpose is for working out, you got to be in that mindset. You can't be here trying to shred and then you want to eat every single thing that's available, especially if you don't have that type of genetics, you know. And at the same time, you can't want to build muscles and then you're not getting enough rest, you're not eating enough food, you're not working out hard enough, you're not pushing enough heavy weights, you know. You got to be mentally prepared. You got to know what you want, and you got to figure out the steps from where you're at to where you want to be, and just work on that. And it's that simple.
All right, now, Jamo, that's awesome what you just said, and I'm feeling you on that. Now, what you just said was the mental piece as it applies to the workout, but now let's take the mental piece and talk about as it applies to our lives and our goals and dreams in our life. Could you add some color to that for us?
Yeah, well, I mean, like, it's like the same principle. Like, mentally, you have to be prepared for the life you have, you know, like the life you're living and where you want to be, what your goal is in life. Because you have to know one thing, like, no matter what you do in life, you're going to be held accountable for it. It don't matter the circumstances you're born in, it don't matter how poor you are, how rich you are, how light you are, how dark you are, how big you are, how strong you are. You got to be prepared to deal with whatever consequences come to you, and you got to be held accountable for every single action that you do, because you can't just be doing things and don't expect to be punished for it, you know what I mean? And at the same time, you can't just be living life recklessly, like, you know, you're the baddest motherfucker out here, because, you know, everybody got their time on the day.
There's always a better motherfucker.
Exactly. Everybody got their time on the day. So you gotta be humble in life, you know, because you could be here now and tomorrow you never know. You could be in a wheelchair or you could be on life support and nobody give a fuck, because you never gave a fuck about anybody while you was out here getting your money, you know what I mean? So you gotta be humble. Life could take a turn anytime, any day. You know, so you just gotta be humble, respect people, and just live.
Hey, Jamo, man, that's dope, dope. Listen, man, do me a favor, man. Tell the people, man, say, yo, fuck with Sean's YouTube channel, man. Hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, man.
Yo, if you just drop what you're doing, once you're looking at this video, hit Sean's YouTube. Subscribe, hit the notification, get all the latest updates on workouts and everything. That's the realest.
Yo, Jamo, appreciate you, man.
No problem,
man. If you want to change information, I'm going to give you my information.
No problem, no problem.
All right, man, peace, man.
All right, man, peace.